Lyndon Johnson was president, and we were in the midst of the Vietnam War. Gas was 32 cents a gallon. Mini skirts were popular. TV shows at the time were Batman and Star Trek, First Air, and they invented Pampers. That was 50 years ago. At that same time, that same year, a young man, 10 years old, walked into Palisades YMCA to learn Judo. His name was Kevin Colton. He was sort of timid and shy back then. What happened? I don't know. He was always the first kid to arrive in the dojo with his highly starched, absolutely perfectly white knee, and he was always the last kid to leave at the end of the day. He was always eager to please and always a hard worker. I remember his mom telling me that after his first promotion, and back then in the tradition of Bill Randall, the first belt was a pink belt, that he wore the belt continuously for a week at home, slept in it, never took it off for a week. Little did I realize that Kevin then would grow up and ultimately be my only student ever to have and operate his own dojo. When I left the Pacific Palisades Y in 1971 to teach at the West Side Y, Kevin came with me. In or around 1973, I quit teaching at the West Side Y because of my medical school commitments, and Kevin continued his training with others until he received his Shodan black belt from Jim Marcinkus in 1976. Kevin studied other jiu-jitsu systems for many years, but came back home to the AJJF in 1993 as a student under Professor Tom Ball. For those of you that know him, you would readily agree that Kevin has devoted his entire life to the martial arts. I am sure that those of you that know him and train under Kevin would probably have a few choice words to describe him. And I do too. The words I would use to describe him are enthusiastic, passionate, dedicated, loyal, family, and friend. When I was asked to introduce Kevin for this award, I was honored, and I would not have missed it for the world. So without further elaboration, please join me in welcoming Professor Kevin Colton to the 50-year club.
Inductee this evening, may I please have Professor Carr up to introduce the next inductee.